while I was in this therapy program there, that I went to this other place, which is where I often go with family and friends, and I always park in the back. As I was coming out of the building, I walked down the pathway where I usually walk, and this lady was sitting in her van, and she was just sitting there. She wasn't moving or anything, and I had to go past her van to get to my car because my car was behind hers. And all of a sudden, I wasn't walking anymore. I was sitting behind her van. I said, "I've never been hit by a car before." She said, "I never hit anybody by a car before either." She said, "I looked in my rearview mirrors and it was clear." If she would have backed up, I would have been crushed. I would have been in heaven because I there's no way I could have escaped. People were starting to gather and I was feeling kind of embarrassed, but they helped me get up. I said, "Are you a Christian?" I said, "Will you pray for me?" I said, I guess they thought I was delirious because I had been hit by a car, but anyway, I thought I could just be healed right there in the parking lot. I wouldn't have to go anywhere else, but that wasn't God's plan. Anyway, they called 911. The police was there and he was taking a report and I said, "Are you a Christian?" I said, "Will you pray for my healing?" He said, "Yeah." He said, "I'm not only a policeman, I'm a minister also." Then I had to go to LGH for x-rays and stuff. Sure enough, there, my pelvic bone was cracked on my left side. I was laying in bed, I said, "Will you pray for me?" I said, "Are you a Christian?" I said, "I was planning to go home. This afternoon I was planning to go and weed my flower bed and put mulch down on my flowers. I need to do that this afternoon." I said, "Will you pray for me?" She said, she halfway shut the door and she says, "Yeah, I'll pray for you, but don't tell my boss." So it took me 3 months. Instead of 8 weeks, it was 3 months. And I just never had so much pain in all my life. I just wasn't used to that kind of pain. And so I thought, well, you know, God must have some purpose for him. He must not be finished with me yet. You have a lot of time to think when it's that way. But anyway, Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 became very precious to me. It always was before. That was my dad's favorite verses, and I just love that. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. And I just felt like he's directing my paths, and he must have something special for me to do that I don't know yet. But he's a good, good father, and I love him, and I'm just glad that I'm still here. So that's my story.